Hello, and welcome back to Ask a Scientist. We received an interesting question on Twitter for Dr. Elisabeth Galarneau, a research scientist who specializes in air quality.
The number of flights and people traveling this year has reduced. Has this positively affected the environment? What are some things everyone can do to reduce air pollution?
There has certainly been a major reduction in flights in Canada and around the world because of COVID-19 travel restrictions. Elisabeth, what can you tell us about the environmental impact this has had?
You're right that air pollution emissions from travel decreased under COVID. That isn't true for all sources, though. And the fuels we use to power, heat, and cool our homes produce more emissions than usual. So what was the overall effect? Air pollution scientists use a variety of tools to answer questions like this. Those tools tell us that COVID restrictions have led to lower air pollution levels. And we've seen that result almost everywhere we've looked. The exception is in Canada's major cities, where one pollutant went up rather than down. That pollutant is called ozone. Now note that ozone in city air is something we want to avoid. It's quite different from the ozone up in the stratosphere that protects us from ultraviolet radiation and skin cancer. The ozone down here in the air we breathe can cause or exacerbate respiratory problems. Ozone is formed by complex chemical reactions among other pollutants in the air. Reduced emissions from transportation affected those reactions and led to ozone that was higher than normal. There are other pollutants that we know less about, and these include a long list of toxic compounds that we're just beginning to understand. They're present in the air at low levels, but can still be associated with toxic effects. As we develop our capabilities to measure and simulate these toxic pollutants, we'll better understand how they're affected by changes in emissions like those we've seen under COVID. As you can see, straightforward questions about air pollution often have complicated answers. Still, we know that cutting emissions generally reduces air pollution, and that choices we make about transportation, energy, and chemicals as individuals and as a society have a real impact.
Wow, I had no idea the ozone was both a protective layer in Earth's stratosphere and a pollutant. Thank you, Elisabeth. Are you curious about the environment? Send us your questions on social media with the hashtag #AskAScientist.